opportunities. So the evidence is telling us that we have, within the city region, there's a strong potential for growth in key sectors. We know that productivity is above national rates in our key sectors, and there are jobs out there that are demanding the higher level skills. But this is not uniform across the city region, so that's something that we need to be mindful of in some of the actions we have in the strategy moving forward. Employment growth and replacement demand due to an ageing workforce, these sit alongside each other in terms of the need to increase skills and employability. We know that our labour supply is likely to grow much more slowly than in other city regions due to the demographics of this area. But we've also got the uncertainty around Brexit as well that may have an impact on future growth rates. So these are other factors that need to be played into the document itself. We've also got, from the Employer Skills Survey, evidence of skill shortages and local recruitment problems that need to be tackled. There's a clear need to reduce inactivity levels within the city region. We know that we've got 130,000 of our residents who are inactive, and of those, around 100,000 are on sickness benefits. We also know there's a need to narrow skills and employment gaps for certain sections of our population and to address poverty both in work and out of work, particularly around wage levels. So what this gives us within this strategy is that opportunity to not only restructure our economy but also upskill and employ our people. However, to do this, we know that we need to change the skills system. There needs to be a step change because it is particularly fragmented, as I will come on to in a minute. So the slide you've got here, what I've tried to do is really summarise the framework. So this is very high level. What we have done with the strategy is built on the ambition that's set out in the single growth strategy. And what we are trying to do is use the skills strategy to act as a bridge between two key pillars. The first one being the need to work for our employers in creating the workforce of tomorrow with high level and appropriate skills. But it must also work for all groups of people across the city region. We must strive to have inclusive growth embedded within this strategy. So we have five key delivery outcomes that are laid out in the middle column, but we also have a sixth outcome that is very much about what we want to do to change our skills system. And I'll just spend a minute just going through each of the outcomes. In terms of the first outcome, we're looking here for a high percentage of our young people to have good attainment in maths, English and digital skills, but also to have high levels of work readiness. And this has come through from the findings of the employer survey, but also if you look at the statistics, the attainment levels for GCSE, the 16-year-olds at level 2, we've not closed the gap in the city region with regional and national rates. So what that means in effect is our young people at 16 spend the time between 16 and 19 catching up, getting a level 2 qualification, when in other areas, 16-year-olds will be going on to get a level 3 qualification and the technical skills that employers want. So we've got that lag that we have to catch up with. By the time we get to 19, by and large, we've caught up, but we do lose a few years there. So we need to look at what we can do about that. Outcome 2 is very much about how we have a higher proportion of the working age population actually in employment, but also in good quality paid jobs. And I've already mentioned the inactivity rates that we have in the city region. And just as an example, if we were to match the Northwest inactivity rate, we'd have 34,000 more people in jobs, in work, in the city region at this point in time. Outcome 3 focuses very much on our growth sectors, and what we're looking for here is higher productivity and a lower incidence of skill shortages within the growth sectors. Outcome 4 is more broadly about how we tackle recruitment difficulties across the piece in all sectors, and particularly how we address the issue of replacement demand. We know there will be in the region of 200 So it's a big number replacement demand that we need to look at. Outcome 5 is very much focused on our employers. It's not all about public money, this strategy. We need to work with our employers to up the level of investment into skills and training. And we know from the employer skills survey that fewer than 1 in 5 of the employers who were surveyed were actually investing in training at this point in time. And then finally, 6th outcome is very much about changing the system and challenging the system to be simpler, to join up more, for there to be more collaborative behaviours both within the city region, but then also in terms of how we challenge back nationally to government. There are a whole range of actions that are flagged up in the document that you've got with your papers. What we have tried to do over the 5-year period of the strategy is to try and focus on a small number of critical actions, because we can't do everything, so we've got to narrow down what collaboratively we're trying to do. So this slide really gives you some of the building blocks to do this, and if I just use outcome 1 as an example, one of the second bullet point on outcome 1 is talking about how to address some of the issues around attainment for young people, that we work with the careers system more and how can we get more effective careers information, advice and guidance, particularly through the careers hub, which is an Ask About Devolution Agreement, and how do we put that now back to the industrial strategy that wants to pilot a small number of careers hubs in city regions. So we're already ahead of the curve on that one. How do we just sort of land that one, get the pilots in our area? One other point just to make on this though, and one of the challenges I've had when I've talked about the strategy with partners, is building blocks are all well and good, but how do we actually achieve that step change? So what we also need to make sure we do is hook up into some of the big aspirational projects that we have as a city region, whether that's the tidal power, digital connectivity and other examples, but we do need to do that aspect as well. In terms of the skills system itself, this warrants, unfortunately, this warrants a full slide, and that's because the employment skills system is highly fragmented, centralised. There's different agencies, different programmes, different funding streams, different groups of people being served, different rules, and nationally there's no common plan. So what we're trying to do here in the Liverpool City region is knit all of that together, but it's not an easy task. So one of the challenges back to all of us is how we work harder to create that system in the city region that is much simpler to access for individuals, for employers, but also for service providers. Aligned to that, we need to work to strengthen our employer engagement. We've got some good examples of that, but again, it's not across the piece. We need to promote and highlight role models, particularly if we're looking to raise aspirations and participation for certain sections of the community. We know we need to do more around work placements and work experience for our young people. We need to have a more personalised delivery, particularly for those who are furthest away from the labour market. How do you help people with complex needs get back into the system? And most importantly, we need to build on what works, and we need to focus on what needs to improve. And you'll notice in the document itself, we've got some examples of some case studies within the city region where we know we have good practice and things are working well, and we want to celebrate those within the strategy. We also need to make sure we have the right research and intelligence to drive the commissioning decisions that we will be doing once we have the adult education budget devolved to the city region in 2019-20. And we also need to make sure that we link up all the various complementary roles that different partners have in delivering this strategy, and that will be one of the actions moving forward. So just finally, in terms of the next steps, following on from today, a final consultation period, particularly to focus on the actions and the implementation, that will run until the 15th of January. We'll continue to do some cross-reference